Good morning, I'm Shauna McCarthy, and welcome to DC News for January 21st. Our student association election is just around the corner. Nominations will be accepted starting Monday at 9 a.m. until February 4th. The student association executive, board of directors, and society president positions are up for grabs, and on February 7th, once all the successful candidates are finalized, the campaigning will begin. Nomination packages are available at the SA Elections Office in UL 106. TED, a group devoted to ideas worth spreading, and UOIT are coming together January 22nd to talk about green innovations by business leaders in the Durham region. The event kicks off at 6 p.m. at the Regent Theatre in Oshawa. The conference, like many TED events, will feature guest speakers sharing their ideas on energy and how we can construct a more sustainable world. There are 7 confirmed speakers, including Christopher DiCarlo and Peter Berg. To register, visit their website. With housing being a priority among students, DC News reporter Ryan Graham shows us UOIT's efforts in making the search a little easier.
UOIT held the first annual housing fair on campus today as students had the opportunity to interact with potential landlords to get an idea of their housing options for next year. I spoke with a potential landlord on how he thinks an event like this helps students.
They get out there, they realize the properties that are licensed, decent, quality, the people that are accessible, and good landlords, that'll help them and make it easier on them than scouring the, they can just come in while they're at class and swing by and look at a lot of different options.
Some of the participants that were also at the event were the City of Oshawa, the Oshawa Fire Department, and the Student Association. I spoke with Paul Hunt of the Oshawa Fire Department to see what he was looking to get out of the housing fair.
I need to talk to the students about housing options, and next year when they are choosing their housing options, that there's some things that they have to be aware of or know when they're looking for suitable housing. So we're here today to talk to them about what could happen if, in the event that they do have a fire, whether they're in a house or a basement apartment or a regular apartment or even on residence. So how to avoid having a fire and end up like the results that we have here today.
Students talked to potential landlords and other campus services to get an idea of what housing options are available to them. Reporting for DC News, I'm Ryan Graham.
Country favorite Aaron Prochette came to Oshawa last night. Our DC News reporter Nathaniel Smith tells us he put on quite the show.
Here is the setting where Canadian country star Aaron Prochette will be performing in celebration of his latest album release, In the Driver's Seat. We spoke with fans who were eagerly awaiting his performance.
Very animated performer, supercharged on stage. It's really a lot of fun to watch him.
Although the main attraction was Aaron Prochette, other bands helped in creating a spectacular event for fans. I also spoke with the country singer himself about his album.
This album, I wanted to be able to play every song on stage and have it entertain my crowd that I typically play to, and I think that's exactly what I hit. Also with radio, you got to be able to make sure that radio wants to play the songs too, so hopefully I hit the mark with all those.
Canadian country singer Aaron Prochette rocked the crowds at the Corral, and with his new upcoming album hitting the shelves, fans can expect a lot of great country music. This is Nathaniel Smith reporting for DC News.
The Leave the Pack Behind campaign starts up on January 24th. This annual 6-week contest stretches across 43 Canadian campuses. There are 4 categories, each requiring a non-smoking buddy to register with you and verify the end results. Prizes including cash will be motivating the smokers to quit entirely or even cut back. The initiative was started in March 2000 by Brock University and is funded by the Ontario Ministry of Health. To register, visit their website. Summer Company, a program sponsored by the Ontario government, is offering returning students ages 15 to 29 up to $3,000 to start their own business. The program helps students prepare business plans and provides one-on-one mentoring and advisory services. Students can now apply online for summer 2011. And now over to Kyle Reynolds with the latest in sports news.
The men's and women's indoor soccer teams are gearing up for the OCAA Regional Championships in March. They both travel to Centennial College this weekend to compete in the first of 3 tournaments before the championships. Head coach of the women's team, David Staley, says he is confident his team has a shot at winning its first provincial title since 2007. The UOIT Ridgebacks men's hockey team was in action last night. As DC News reporter Adriana Pacheco tells us, the team is working hard to move up in the rankings.
Almost a a shutout last night as the UIT Ridgebacks beat the York Lions 4-1. It was a tense game, with the final goal being scored with only seconds to spare. Ridgebacks captain and center, Nathan Spaulding, scored the Ridgebacks' second goal of the game. He says this was a big game for his team, and that was on their minds going in.
We knew it was a big game tonight for sure. There's a lot on the line, especially with them kind of getting closer to us on the points. So we knew we had to, take advantage of the momentum whenever we got it. And, it was kind of back and forth, but that big kill at the start of the third period really helped us out, I think.
Head coach Marlon Mueller says his team played well, but could have done better, and will now be looking forward to their next game to improve.
I thought tonight we got a fast start, got an early lead. And then I wouldn't say we were a great team tonight, but we were a good team tonight with exceptional penalty killing.
Well, so we're going to watch some Waterloo video tomorrow. We lost 3-2 there last week. And if we have any hope of catching Waterloo and putting a push on for fourth place in our league, we need to win tomorrow in Waterloo. So we're going to have to be a whole lot better than we were tonight.
The Ridgebacks next get set to travel to Kitchener on Friday, where they will go up against Waterloo. Their next home game will be the 28th here at the Campus Ice Center against the Mustangs. Reporting for DC News, I'm Adrienne Pacheco.
The UIT women's hockey team is looking for its first win since December 4th. After losing four straight, the Ridgebacks currently sit in eighth place with 13 points. They face off against the last place Mustangs tonight in London at 7:30 p.m. Things are looking up for the Durham Lords women's volleyball team. They're on a two-game winning streak entering tonight's game in Sudbury against the red-hot Cambrian Golden Shield. The Lords currently sit in fifth place in the Eastern Conference, while Cambrian hopes to break a three-way tie for first place. The action starts tonight at 5. Speaking of red-hot, the Lords men's volleyball team hopes to extend its undefeated record tonight at 7 against the men from Cambrian College. The Lords have won 10 straight and lead the Eastern Conference with 20 points. Both men's and women's teams compete against the Boreal Vipers in Sudbury tomorrow afternoon. And if that's not enough campus sports to follow for this weekend, the men's and women's basketball teams travel to Barrie tonight to battle against the Georgian Brown Grizzlies. The women's team is looking to snap a two-game losing streak, while the men can bounce up to second place in the Eastern Conference with a win tonight. Now over to Andrew Santos for the latest in entertainment.
Every Saturday until March 19th, students and staff can visit E.P. Taylor's for a chance to win tickets to see Taylor Swift. This contest is open to both students and staff on campus. No purchase is necessary. The lucky winner will be announced on March the 21st. For more information, contact E.P. Taylor's Pub. Durham College and UOIT's annual cultural show, Pangea, is gearing up for another successful year. Students who can sing, dance, or play an instrument are invited to audition. Auditions will be held on January 25th and January 26th in the Simcoe Residence Dance Studio. This year's show will take place on March the 24th at 5 p.m. in the school gymnasium. For audition times and bookings, contact Catherine Bremner at the Student Center. As part of the Student Association's Winterfest Comedy Night, a special guest entertained crowds at the Regent Theatre last night. DC News videographer Miranda Roach has more.
Hilarious comedian Sugar Sammy made his return to Durham Regent last night with special guest Ron Jassal at the Regent Theatre in Oshawa for the Student Association's Winterfest Comedy Night. This was the first ever SA event at the historic theatre, and it was a huge success. SA Vice President of Campus Life Brad Jones was more than pleased with the event.
Yeah, it was a great turnout. First ever event at the Regent, so we definitely love the amount of people that were here, and we're going to totally do more events here because it was awesome.
Some students have seen Sammy online, but this was the first time live for many.
I actually seen him on the internet first and thought he was hilarious, and then I went to the pub last year for when he came down again, and he was hilarious.
I'm a huge Sugar Sammy fan to start with. And I just thought getting to see him live was just amazing.
This was the first performance the comedian had done in a while, and he was thrilled to be back in laughter.
Overall, it was amazing. The response was great. Like, we all got a great response. And Kartik, it was his first time today. He did a great job. He was amazing.
Unfortunately, we weren't allowed to get any footage from the show, but we can assure you that students were LMAOing. Reporting from the Regent Theater in downtown Oshawa, for DC News, I'm Miranda Roach.
Another year on campus means another year with one of the most talked about hypnotists in Canada, Tony Lee. Lee is hosting an event at E.P. Taylor's Pub tonight from 8 to 9 p.m. Tickets are $5 for students in advance and $7 at the door. There are also special rates for guests. Are you ready to hit the slopes? Your student association is and hopes you are too. As part of your SA's Winterfest celebrations on campus, students can attend an all-day ski trip at Brimacombe Mountain in Kirby on January the 22nd. A bus will be picking up students from the North Campus at 8 a.m. Tickets are $10 for students and $20 for guests. For more information, contact Sam Power at sam.power@dc-uoyt.ca or visit www.sa-winterfest.com. And that's what's making news this Friday, January the 21st. From all of us at DC News, thank you for watching. Be sure to join us again next Friday at 2 p.m. for the news that matters to you. Have a great weekend.